What happened to air supply?
In April and May of 1975, a young Englishman, Graham Russell, met a young Australian, Russell Hitchcock. While they are cast members of Andrew Lloyd Webber's Australian version of the stage musical Jesus Christ Superstar, they rapidly discovered that they shared a developing understanding and passion for all things musical, causing Graham to show Russell the songs he had composed and a desire to follow their aspirations and ambitions in that realm of music grew. The lads might be found singing and playing in local bars for next to nothing in terms of cash, but for a lot in terms of experience. Graham and Russell discovered the public was incredibly responsive to their music and style of rock and ballads. Then in 1976, the stage play ended and they were already in the process of releasing a single under the name Air Supply, which had come to Graham in a dream. Chrissy Hammond was a member of the group at the time. In Australia, the single Love and Other Bruises was welcomed with minor popularity and attention. Now completely engaged in the real work of composing music, the lads made an album called Love and Other Bruises in 1977. That, by the way, reached number 2 on the Australian charts. The next song, Empty Pages, peaked at number 18 in Australia. By this point, Hammond had departed and Jeremy Paul had taken his position. Air Supply was ecstatic to receive an offer to open for Rod Stewart on a tour of Australia, Canada, and the United States. However, Jeremy Paul later quit the band to pursue his career. Later that year, their album The Whole Thing Started was published, with the single Do What You Do reaching number 16 on the Australian charts. There had been no promotions or professional training up to this point, yet they had met with success at every step. The increased public exposure that the pair earned while opening for Rod Stewart brought Air Supply to a broader international audience. Live Support, which had been recorded in 1978, was released as their fourth album in 1979. This one featured Air Supply's first big hit, Lost in Love, which went to number 1 in Australia. It was subsequently re-recorded for distribution in the United States and it proved to be the beginning of Graham Russell's lengthy streak of international hits. By the year 1980, Air Supply had finally made its way to the general population in the United States. Clive Davis, the owner of the Arista Record Company, assisted with the publication of the album Lost in Love, which had three songs that reached the top 5 on the Hot 100. Lost in Love peaked at number 3 in May of 1980, Every Woman in the World peaked at number 5 in December 1980, and All Out of Love peaked at number 2 in September 1981. They were the first of Air Supply's 8 top 5 chart singles. As their CD reached multi-platinum status, America flocked to the Australian boys. Huge success came when The One That You Love, a 1981 record, debuted at number 2 on the US album charts, and the singles The One That You Love peaked at number 1 in 1981 in August, Here I Am peaked at number 5 in November 1981, and Sweet Dreams peaked at number 5 in March of 1982, and they were well received by millions, propelling Air Supply's 6th album to multi-platinum status. In celebration of The One That You Love, Air Supply received a treasured BMI award. Now and Forever was released in 1982, but remained at number 25 on the album charts in August of 1982, while the first single from the album, Even the Nights Are Better, soared to number 5 in September of 1982. The next singles were Young Love at number 38 in October 1982 and Two Less Lonely People in the World at number 38 in January 1983. Similarly, Now and Forever received yet another multi-platinum accolade. Due to high retailer demand, the 1983 album Greatest Hits peaked at number 7 in August of 1983, and the song Making Love Out of Nothing at All remained at number 2 for 2 weeks in October 1983. Another album, also titled Air Supply, reached number 26 on the album charts, while the single Just As I Am reached number 19 in July of 1985. Just As I Am received VH1's coveted number 1 video award for 1985. Power of Love from August of 1985 was a hit album, with the title song being converted into a TV commercial. Hearts in Motion was released in shops in 1986. Lonely Is the Night in September 1986 and One More Chance in November 1986 became favorites of Air Supply fans worldwide. Graham and Russell created and performed the Christmas album in 1987, a much-anticipated holiday offering. Throughout the Christmas season, radio stations play the most popular and lovely songs from that album, Love Is All and Eyes of a Child, both written by Graham. And it has been played on the radio and in stores for customers every Christmas since. Russell branched out on his own from 1987 to 1990, recording a solo album, Russell Hitchcock, and releasing a single, Swear to Your Heart. Graham retired to a favorite remote location to write and compose. He was also working on some concepts that had been brewing in the back of his head since infancy. The seeds of his eventual 2-CD Heart of the Rose record were most likely down there and there. Fortunately for fans, Graham and Russell reformed in 1991, producing the cult classic The Earth Is album and the single Without You. They immediately expand their scope beyond the borders of the United States and Australia, resulting in a world tour. Air Supply's international fame expanded by leaps and bounds over time. Since then, both foreign fans and the media have held Air Supply in high esteem. Vanishing Race was a one-of-a-kind 1993 CD that had emotional significance for the men due to a book about the struggle of Native Americans Graham got as a gift. Goodbye peaked at number 48 on the Adult Contemporary chart in the United States in July 1993. Air Supply's work on this album brought them even greater popularity. It's Never Too Late and Goodbye received gold and platinum ratings, respectively. News From Nowhere was another record with emotional significance for the lads due to a catastrophic fire that Graham and his wife experienced at their home. It first aired in 1995. The song Someone peaked at number 50 in the US Adult Contemporary charts, and Air Supply was once again touring extensively worldwide. The success of Air Supply has constantly risen as a result of the expanded fan base. International radio and media continued to promote Air Supply, as did new and old fans in numerous nations across the world. The band completed an Asian tour that took them to Indonesia, Thailand, Singapore, Hong Kong, Taiwan, and the Philippines. A 16-piece string section also joined Air Supply for the recording of their Greatest Hits Live album, a CD and film later converted into a DVD of a live concert in Taiwan in 1995. The Book of Love, produced solely by Graham Russell and released in November 1997, was the first album to be recorded at a studio in Utah, where he and his wife also had a wildlife rehabilitation area. Once, Air Supply's lone instrumental is included on The Book of Love, written by Jed Moss, who is a former Air Supply pianist, with minor touches by Graham. The Definitive Collection, a comprehensive CD with all the successes, was published in August 1999 and includes the original version of Lost in Love as well as other beloved tracks. Every song has notes and quotations from Graham and Russell. The long-awaited DVD, The Definitive Collection, arrived. It consists primarily of the songs from the CD that have the same name, as well as images, interviews, and trivia. The long-awaited album Mumbo Jumbo, the duo's first recording in 8 years, was released in May 2010. Mumbo Jumbo was produced by Graham Russell and engineered by Odds On's Sean O'Dwyer, whose credits include Pink Floyd, Randy Newman, and Blink-182. It was recorded at Graham Russell's home studio near Park City, Utah, and Odds On state-of-the-arts facilities in Las Vegas, with top session musicians and an orchestra. The song Dance With Me was among the 14 tunes published by Odds On's label and earned Air Supply a big feature in Billboard magazine's headline, Still Supplying the Hits After 35 Years. Air Supply's new song was the number one most added track on the FMQB Adult Contemporary 40 chart, as well as one of the most added on the R&R Radio and Records Adult Contemporary chart and the Media Base Adult Contemporary chart. Just weeks after composer and vocalist Graham Russell was honored with a BMI Millionaire Certificate, recognizing 3 million performances of the duo's hit All Out of Love. Russell's solo album, Tennessee the Nashville Sessions, a two-disc compilation of 20 songs recorded with Better Angles Music, was released in May 2011. They record their live concert in Jerusalem, Israel for a DVD. Sanctuary and Everywhere, two new tracks are included on the DVD. In October of 2011, Sanctuary was published as a single on iTunes. The musical Lost in Love began production in 2012 with the approval of the Air Supply pair. Air Supply was ultimately admitted to the ARIA Hall of Fame in December 2013, 38 years after they were founded in Sydney. The event was hosted at the Star Event Center in Sydney. The CD, DVD, and Blu-ray live in Hong Kong by Air Supply on Evolution Media captured one of their legendary performances, vividly revealing a real musical sensation. 2015 also saw the 40th anniversary celebration and world tour of Air Supply, which covered Indonesia, Malaysia, Singapore, numerous states in the United States, and more. In addition, hundreds of admirers signed up for a 40th anniversary party on Facebook, which took place on May 12th of that year. And starting in December 17th of 2021, they have 31 concerts lined up as of the end of November 2021 when I'm recording this. So they are staying busy and they have plenty of shows, and it's mainly around the United States and Canada. There's also a show in Chile. And that's what happened to Air Supply. Thank you for watching. Like and subscribe if you haven't already. And there should be a playlist on screen of some of my favorite Air Supply songs. It'll take you through a trip through memory lane. Thank you for watching. Let me know who I should do next, and I'll see you in the next video.